one of those days that, you know, I find myself sitting by somebody I've been seeing on screen for so long. Today, I am starstruck. I watch his movies and you can't afford not to laugh. I tracked him down to his hotel room, but popularly known as Mr. Ibu, and he's in Ghana. First of all, should I hug you? Should I shake your hand? Do I kiss your cheek? Which one?
Hey,
pick one.
That last one is no bad.
Okay, so why don't we do this? I'll hug you.
Please, let's reserve the other ones and do some hugging.
Is it okay now?
Can
we let go now? You can let go now. Okay for now.
But if I somehow continue, not mine. Hey.
You're welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
It's such a pleasure having you here. So you've been in Ghana since Friday. Mm. Mm-hmm. Have you been enjoying the environment and the scenery?
Yeah, I have, because that's reason for me to enjoy the environment. Mm-hmm. First of all, before ever you think about coming to Ghana, Accra to be precise, you'll be having something in the back of your mind, relaxed place, mm-hmm. where you can have good sleep, and then meet people, you know, responsible men and women. It's hospitable people, I must confess.
Have you had any Ghanaian food? Are you picking any of the languages? Anything?
I'm picking some languages, some difficult ones though. Like to say Boko.
Boko. But the Boko comes with a punch.
A lot of emphasis. Boko, that means it's good.
Yeah.
The other one is Akwaaba.
Akwaaba, you're welcome.
Welcome. The other one is Wuhuye.
Wuhutisein. No. I'm supposed to ask you Wuhutisein.
Uh-huh.
Then you will say Mehuye.
Mehuye, papa.
Papa. Papa. Serious.
Hey. On my vein, they walk. Another one is Midase.
Midase. Oh, that is,
much.
Thank you.
Aye.
So, how does it feel knowing that you always, when you enter a place, I mean, you just put a smile on people's faces automatically. You don't even have to do anything. It's just people are happy to see you, they're enlightened to see you, and they laugh.
I think I would say I'm not surprised because I started from my country, Nigeria. Even in my house, once I enter, my wife's younger sister will start laughing.
She just laugh for no reason?
No, this is not. I didn't say anything. Oh, wake up! Oh, wake up! Nothing happened. For my mama see me now, my mom start laughing. If you laugh and I never talk, when I talk, what will happen?
So you don't have a problem when people see you and start laughing. You don't have any problem with that.
No, you're not
offended.
It's a common phenomenon for me. It has been. I'm about almost 35 years in the industry.
Absolutely. And is this something that has been with you? You know, some people pick it up when they come into the profession. Have you always been naturally funny, or is something that happened when you got into the movie industry?
The issue is that whatever you do, you keep on increasing your ideas, your, you know, creativity every minute, mm-hmm. every day, just like that. Like you as a pretty girl, you know, you distract people whenever you talk. You don't know how people out there see you.
Mm-hmm.
And they are distracted with the way you coin your words.
Uh-huh.
Number one, you are schooled.
Mm-hmm.
And you are using those components judiciously to make sure that this department of life is well-held family. God bless you. That's exactly what is happening in my own side. I don't go for your hand. When I hear that, so. If I fall now, I may don't fire me.
You have made so many movies. My personal favorite, I was telling you earlier on, was Civil War.
Yeah.
Civil War, where, if you've not seen it, you were married to two women, and they all had twins at the same time.
Yeah.
And it was such a challenging role, but you took it up so wonderfully.
Yes. The issue, I was actually trying to put peace in my home. Very difficult. I find it very difficult to put the peace because I have very difficult in-laws who don't really, really understand life. All they do is to make sure that whatever that can favor their children is in place.
That's what they think about.
So, in the course of this, I think after about maybe 1 month of arrival from the hospital, you know, my wife's like, who is the best woman? And they started entering my rooms again. And then, before you know it,
you're pregnant again.
Hey.
You see, I don't know how this happened, but I ran tests on your wife and discovered that Nkechi here is pregnant.
Nkechi?
Yes.
You're pregnant? Hey! Why? Why must I be pregnant? You want to kill me?
It's alright, it's alright.
Doctor!
How old are
you? And I also discovered that Shola is pregnant too.
Abasimba. Why? What's the meaning of this? Why? For God's sake!
Egba mi o. She obirin ma fra won loyun ni. Ah! Now we do am.
For God's sake! Somebody had delivered 4 months ago. Why would you be pregnant, for God's sake?
Please.
Hey.
Ah. Huh? That is not even the major problem. The problem now is that we did the scan and found out that both women are carrying twins.
Twins?
Yes.
So
twins.
Doctor.
Doctor.
Yes. Twins.
Doctor. And you allow it? Why?
Look.
You allow them?
Please, what is the...
You are allowed to use...
Calm
you are allowed to use
calm down.
Ah. What is...
It's okay. Be a man.
Doctor, Alfred. Doctor, please. Alfred.
Let's say in real life it had happened to you. That two women had twins at the same time. They get pregnant and have twins again at the same time.
Why don't you use your mother and say, God forbid, what is that? Are they harsh like foul? Happy dog. How can they produce children like that? Na egg. A zebu bed. I beg.
Well, we are waiting for room service to bring his food. Somebody has ordered food and the room service is bringing it. So,
yes.
You know, we'll wait. Light soup.
Yeah.
With rice and lunch is ready. You've done so many movies.
Mm.
How come Mr. Ibu was the one that was, you know, very, very popular?
Maybe because I was so stupid in that one. I was completely an idiot for that work.
You're calling yourself stupid?
If that character gets sense, that Ibu way they see it gets sense. Not me.
That's nice. Hey.
Let me see it.
I tell you, it's wonderful. Come, what's this? You want to swallow this thing? I've told you not to cut Giga by Oagbu. You want to kill yourself? Come on, reduce it.
No, Papa, I can swallow it.
You are mad. Come on, remove it.
Are you enjoying your food? Am I distracting you, disturbing you with the food?
No, Mary will chop it. Doesn't Mary will chop this food.
Okay, all right, great. So,
Go, somebody go wash the spoon. We'll chop together.
Okay. Your early days, you know, I'm told that, I read about you, that you had a very, very difficult background.
Yeah. Poor.
Very poor.
They use poor.
Very poor. Yeah. Actually, use poor.
Yeah.
Yes, very poor. Can you share?
Photographer.
You were a photographer. Tell me a bit about your background.
Was a hairdresser.
Hairdresser. That was the bit I didn't get.
Yeah.
You were doing women's hair or,
yeah,
you know.
Women's hair.
So you can style my hair now.
Any kind of style. All style. In fact, if I didn't go to work, my office won't get enough money because the girls, all of them needed me.
Was it because you were good with like personal relationships or you were good with the hair?
Personal relationship. I'm good too. I create styles.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, if you were that good at it, I mean, was it something that you thought you could do for a while?
No.
Not at all, because times were hard.
And again, I had a mind to put food, not only on my table, my mom, my siblings.
Were you the eldest of the children?
No. We believe that as a man, you must struggle.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know where richness is coming from, but go ahead to struggle.
You have to struggle.
And believe that you are the winner. That boy show me Pepe. The idiot. He knows we're not anything. I told him, let's do this thing just normal for us to get money to repair our clubs. And the guy said yes. All of a sudden, after first round, second round, the guy started pounding me like Balerian. You found me so day my face changed. I'll not submit myself again.
So did you win any titles or, you know, because you were beating once, you just decided to disappear?
Boxing? Are they crazy? Who I win? I stopped there.
They beat you and then you stopped?
Oh, after the beating, I respect myself.
I'm here at this hotel room and we're having lunch together today, Mr. John Okafor, also known as Mr. Ibu. Let me take this one before we continue the interview.
Okay.
Can I? The soap is not bad.
It's not bad.
It's not bad. It's not bad at all.
I did my first commercial work, 1994.
1994.
Then it was an Igbo flick. Mm-hmm. The one that pushed me ahead was Agony.
Yeah, Agony.
That was 1998.
I see. What did you do with your very... You can drink your water. You can drink your water. Can I rub your back once you drink the water? Let me rub your back.
Mark it.
I should eat it. Okay. Is that good?
You're kidding. You're very kidding.
So, what did you do? What did you do with your first big check?
I lured my siblings to school. Then I discovered lazy ones and those who are serious to go to school, and some of my relations too. And those of them, I want to go to market, start their own trade, and give them little go and start.
I see.
Very important.
What he's telling you, if you didn't hear him, because that's, you know, he's concentrating on the food so much. Is that he sends most of his siblings to school, and the people in his family that wanted to trade and all that, you know, he helped them out to go about their business. Your choice of scripts, people are very particular about the roles that, you know, they pick. Your line is comedy. Do you do strict comedy or sometimes you blend it with, you know?
Well, I'm a versatile actor. I do other contemporary stories and even epic films.
Epics.
I reject script because if you involve cigarettes, then I'm going to smoke.
You don't smoke?
At all. I can't sit here, somebody smoking here. It's not possible.
It's not possible.
I can vomit everything in my tummy.
If you have to play a part with somebody who smokes, that one you can't do it. You can't do it either.
I can't be in that scene. I don't drink though.
You don't drink? No alcohol?
No.
No alcohol, no smoking?
No, I don't drink alcohol. But if you insist, I can take, but I can't smoke. But if I take it more than
necessary,
the quantity I feel, like half cup, then you spoil the work for the day.
That what? That's it? You feel sleepy and...
I'll start laughing. No. Just laughing and... beating people.
You know, normally when you're... Oh, okay.
Oh. I feel like continuing with it.
No, we have to finish the interview first. You know that?
Yeah.
Okay, so wait. The next one is for you.
Yeah. Continue. Loves it. That's sweet part.
All these things you talked about, I'm sure maybe some people may be surprised that you don't drink, you don't smoke, you can't stand it. Are there any other things about you that, you know, your fans do not know about you?
So many.
So many. Like what?
I don't like involving myself in anything that can bring blood out from me or from anybody. I don't fight.
You don't fight?
I don't do anything that can make you waste your blood, either hit you or punch you or whatever. But don't do me first. If you do me and make me lose part of my body, run, oh. Run, oh. You hear me? If I get up, you when they separate the fight, you when they watch the fight, you when they pass, you don't even know where they can bring the fight, you go collect some before you come out of that place.
Let's talk about family. You're married? Why are you looking at me like that? I just asked a question.
You have your uncle, I never married now. What do you tell me?
No, but there are people who are not married.
If I be your uncle, Rich now, never marry. What would be your advice?
Get married.
Oh. I don't marry.
So you're married?
Mm.
With children?
I want to tell you that my eldest son is 23 years.
Your eldest son is 23 years?
Yes. The youngest is about 2.
2 year old. Wow. What plans do you have for the future? I know most of the actors are crossing over into producing movies and, you know, they're getting behind the camera instead of in front of it. Yeah. Have you produced any movies? Have you?
I've done so many movies. I'm the latest on board. I did, I want to produce Ibu Rum Man in America. I'm going to be shooting in America, Nigeria and Ghana. So I'm using some of the Ghanaians.
You're using some of the Ghanaian actors as well. Okay.
I'll run the audition here, but I have my stars there. Our four stars, Majid, Tilapia, Appiah, my very good friend.
Jackie Appiah.
Jackie Appiah. Okay. I have Juliet
Ibrahim.
Ibrahim.
Okay. All right. But you'll be having an audition here. I'll
be having an audition for other scenes.
Other scenes. For the main characters you have other scenes. Mm. Okay, great. And before we go, do you have any favorite things, like, you know, what do you do during your spare time, your favorite kind of music, favorite food, things like that? Share some of your favorite things with me.
My leisure time, I watch football.
What's your favorite football team?
You know, God created the heavens and gave it blue. God created the river, water, and gave it blue.
You're a Chelsea fan.
Oh my God.
You're a Chelsea fan. You're a Chelsea fan.
Forever and ever.
No team comes close.
My last girl, her name is Chelsea.
Oh, that bad?
To tell you how far I've gone.
Why people are saying that now you guys, you're losing your momentum and all that, you're going down.
A step is the beginning of 1 million miles.
Uh-huh.
We moved FA Cup and Champions League the same time.
Uh-huh.
That was last season.
Uh-huh.
This season we failed.
Uh-huh.
We move ahead to carry second to the biggest. It's not a child's play.
Chelsea fan?
Okay. I say that again.
You know.
Jesse, may God bless you.
Don't finish the food without me.
No.
You're supposed to.
You are doing more talking.
I'm doing more talking, you're doing more eating. So what, let's say in the next 5 years, where do you see yourself from here?
I be God. Now God know where I go there. I go don't do movie. When we say if I do one, the whole world go shake. That's my ambition.
That's your ambition.
Yes. And my friends are supporting. I have about 2-3 good friends in Ghana here.
Mm-hmm.
Elijah Wasiu, Coleman, Divine. Mm-hmm. Divine is from who? Mm-hmm. Chooks is the name. God bless them.
God bless them all. I'm really glad that I met you.
Thank you.
Really, really glad that I met you. We had lunch today. And I know that, you know, you have, of course, enjoyed this experience with me as well. And like he said, he will be, you know, having an audition for his latest movie. So Mr. Ibu runs mad in America. So make sure that those of you who want to get into the industry, you know, you keep your fingers crossed. Thank you. Okay, there's one thing I want you to do for me. Since you're a Chelsea fan, Chelsea and Manchester are playing right now. No, let's just assume.
Okay.
Can you run commentary for me? Chelsea, Manchester playing, you know, who's going? Let's go.
I will run better commentary for you now. And I will tell you who will score out. Ladies and gentlemen, the ball moves now from the center circle. Finds who? That is Hazard now. Has somebody on him. He beat him with a clear. Push the ball forward the right flank. And that's Manchester United coming forward. He beat him with a clear. And it's a corner. A corner, first corner coming to Chelsea. 15 minutes now go to step to the story. A chance. That is Hazard going to play now. A high one. It is inside the 18 yard. And a header from Lampard. It's a goal!